warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Afifa Rasli.
And I'm Faik Aydin.
And welcome to TabZone. And in TabZone, we're going to talk about some of the issues in Brunei-Darussalam that we, the Bruneians especially, should be concerned with. And what's the topic for today?
Topic for today is identity. So we can cover a number of things.
Yeah.
But I think we should kind of introduce our guest first.
Yeah, sure.
So we have here Aizuddin.
Yes, hello.
So are you enjoying the surroundings?
Yes, I do.
That's good. So are you kind of, what are you hoping to get from this conversation?
Just a good conversation, I guess.
That's great. And what we have here, we have Shazwan and Yusuf.
Hello.
So you're looking very colorful today.
Yes, as always.
And you brought yourself some notes as well.
Yes, well, to make myself organized.
That's good. I have just everything on the iPad,
yes.
So...
I'm sticking to the traditional method.
Just a pen and
yes.
It's good. And we have here Bangku Khadija.
Assalamualaikum.
Yes. You are very composed. You are kind of ready for this conversation.
Yeah, this is my identity. So let's start with them.
Yeah.
And the identity for you, Andrew.
Yes.
When you think of identity, how would you define it?
Identity itself.
Yeah, identity, yeah. In general context.
In general context, for identity could define individual or a thing, but for an individual, it's what defines me.
Mm.
Yeah. Yes.
Would you have an example for that?
Example, identity. I'm a Bruneian.
Yeah.
So I am a Bruneian. It defines me, and I have an identity of a Bruneian.
Okay.
Yes.
And identity, in my opinion, would mean that how people would see or view me from being unique from any other person.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to be seen similar to anyone else. I think that's basically it.
Okay. Yeah, I agree with that. It's about who you are and what people see in you, like how you present yourself in front of those people. And then, yeah.
Okay, now that we, you know, have a basic introduction of what our topic for today, and what would you consider? I mean, if we put it in Bruneian context, I mean, how do you identify yourself as a Bruneian?
Hmm.
Yeah, okay. I can say that I am a very traditional type of person. I enjoy everything that includes like Brunei's traditions and culture, which also includes Brunei's traditional food, and then instruments, even and traditional songs and music.
Mm-hmm.
And so, when I did my degree back in UBD, I joined Golden Parents Club.
Yeah.
And I remember we performed in one of UBD's events, and during that time, our VC, Dr. Zhou Kunan, approached us, and he said, traditional is beautiful, and you all, which refer to us, are the reasons why Brunei continue to be beautiful traditionally and culturally.
So
that is beautiful.
So Gulikanan is the musical
musical composition. I get a chance to play the gong,
as
well as Hadra. So if you ask me what identify me as a Bruneian, I think my interest and my passion towards those Brunei traditions and culture that reflects me as Bruneian.
So would you say so as well?
Probably something similar. I believe that, you know, when you ask me how do we identify ourselves as a Bruneian, I believe it comes from this question, like, how do you identify yourself?
Mm.
So some people, they identify themselves through their religious faith, and some through their occupational status, and of course through nationality as well.
Yeah.
So by telling others that I am actually Bruneian, it doesn't tell how I as a Bruneian think and what do I significantly value.
Mm.
So based on the way I would say that I differ from other Bruneians.
Okay.
Based on the I think and believe in my thought, but I found myself similar to everyone else as we share the same love and the desire to contribute to our beloved country, Brunei Darussalam.
And would you say so as well?
Yes, well, what identifies me as a Bruneian is language and appearance.
Okay.
So language, we speak Bahasa Brunei as our daily conversation. And appearance, we can tell if a person is a Bruneian or not.
And how?
Yes, this is the hardest part. How a Bruneian looks like a Bruneian. Okay, maybe the way we dress and how we look. We look as our hairstyle.
Probably this line to the traditional Baju Kurung as well.
Yes.
I mean, would you say that things like normalization with the fatwa in terms of national identity and national pride?
Oh, yes. Yes. In terms of fashion, right. Well, we are open to the outside world now, especially the availability of the internet, the social medias. So just look at the teens nowadays. They are influenced by pop cultures, punk, they follow the hairstyle, like Koreans. They follow the Korean hairstyle.
So would you say so?
I would have to agree with you. I believe that you're actually confused with the word modernization and westernization. I would see modernization as a positive movement, and westernization is more about the destruction of indigenous culture and replace it with a more westernized one. So probably in this case it would be a colonized one. Basically what we're experiencing in modernization is we're accumulating all these positive attributes from developing countries or developing societies and bring it into our societies and adapt to this.
Can you think of any examples of that?
I would have to mention that in
modernizations. Obviously, modernizations when modern, so everything is changing, you know. For example, in terms of maybe education, certain types of system, and then more or less it actually changed whatever that is traditions and locals. To me, I don't really see modernizations as a threat, but it's more to like a challenge, you know. It's becoming more challenging for us as Bruneians to actually maintain our identity because of this modernization and westernization. As far as I can say, as far as I can see, our government, through ministries, and NGOs, they have made excellent effort in trying to preserve and maintain our national identities and concept, and one of them is the MIB. So I believe that like if we continue to actually remind each other like who we are, where we come from, I'm sure that we can actually get over whatever the challenge is caused by the modernization.
So it's interesting, you mentioned that you don't see modernization as a threat or globalization. So do you, what you have to say aren't having a limit of what we should take from the modernization or globalization?
Yes. Because
you said you didn't get serious as a threat,
but there are some groups who feel that there's a need to limit it. One of them, we know that the children, because ours was a PP teachers,
teaching attachment,
secondary schools, and that's been my experience. Some of the students, they prefer to like, they thought that watching YouTube is much more better than listening to the teacher. It actually gave me a headache. You know, like to tell them no, it's not good. It's not good to do that. It's not good to think that way. Why? Because it's too much exposure. Modernization.
I think that's just one. Like, have you had similar experiences as well? Just in terms of kind of what you've seen as well in terms of
that's basically what I've seen with the young children. So do you agree there should happen a limit to modernization?
Definitely, we should set a limit to what we're taking from other countries. So we have to make sure that this kind of what we're taking from other countries is suitable and could be adapted in our country.
of you as well.
Okay.
So I believe, for example, in terms of communication again, like social networking sites,
Back
in the olden days, we had this people sending invitations, wedding invitations, or perhaps birthday invitations to houses, to their relatives and neighbors. But now with the social networking sites, people could just create an event and click, they could just invite anyone on just one click and click everyone on their Facebook list.
Yeah, but we need to acknowledge that after this modernization and then westernization, globalization, it has its own good as well as negative impact that we need to.
But basically, from what we've been discussing, it's more like a technology in terms of the schooling, but how would you say an identity, for example?
Identity.
Yeah. Should that be element of modernization because would it be a threat to how our reliance identity in the future?
Okay, yes. Well, it depends on the person. The more educated you are, the more differently how you see things, how you perceive things.
Yeah.
Okay. So, if the person is well educated, then he or she would set the limit itself on how he or she take the information and the other things. So I guess that's from an individual point of view, but I do think socially,
in a group,
society.
Yeah.
Yes, I think we should, because what about those kids and the teenagers? They would think it's right.
Usually, these children, especially they tend to like swallow whatever that
is.
You know, they haven't reached that stage where they can actually think what's appropriate for them or not.
Yeah.
What they know is that look nice.
Yes.
That look good.
Yeah, but from your previous point on the YouTube and classes and they thought that the students thought it would be much better than listening to the teachers.
Mm-hmm.
I would say I'm half on this because I do think that technology in classes should be commercial and encouraged, but I do agree there should be a limit. There's they should be able to take a balance between listening to the teachers and also finding outside sources as well. So I would say that we truly should not encourage them to do it.
Yeah, because even the Ministry of Education right now are trying to promote the technology.
Yeah.
They need to make sure that whatever that they learn from the technology, it will benefit them in terms of education and knowledge. Not those, YouTube and so on.
But there's also the education, in terms of education, we're talking about identity. In schools, because of the SPN 21, there's the religious, Islamic religious knowledge has been, it's a must now for everyone to study, and also Islam Raja, Malawi courses. So I think that's a very good example of how we could maintain our identity as a Bruneian.
So I guess that's a lot of points to cover.
Yeah.
A lot that we discovered kind of going through education and technology. So I think we want to hear what other people have to say about it as well.
So seeing a bit.